members of the St. Thomas community walked out of class to demand climate action on March 15th.
Vandals shattered a Virgin Mary statue in Ireland Hall.
Those issues and more today on Top Stories. Hello, everyone. Thank you for joining us for this edition of Top Stories. I'm Althea Larson.
In this show, we give you a rundown of Tommy Media's biggest stories. I'm Emily Haugen. The 13 MIAC presidents will consider whether to expel St. Thomas from the conference on April 18th. MIAC rivals complain about the university's relatively larger enrollment and athletic success. To expel St. Thomas, the MIAC schools must vote to change the conference bylaws. Currently, the only basis for expulsion would be for unethical or illegal behavior, which are not alleged. The Tommy's first season in a new conference would be the 2021 season, 1 year after the 100th anniversary of the founding of the MIAC by St. Thomas, St. John's, Hamlin, McAllister, and Gustavus Adolphus.
Vandals shattered a Virgin Mary statue in Ireland Hall March 3rd. University President Julie Sullivan called the act a disgrace, but said it was not a bias-motivated incident. According to an email from President Sullivan, students involved in the incident were identified in a St. Thomas public safety investigation and will be subject to the student conduct process. Campus Ministry and Residence Life are working to replace the statue.
In solidarity with the International Youth Climate Strike, members of the St. Thomas community walked out of class to demand climate action on March 15th. Videographer Drew Bauman, Chief Video Editor Jack Stanek, and I have the full story. As snow melted on the first sunny Friday of March, St. Thomas students, faculty, and staff walked out of class with a call for change.
The climate change is happening, it's human caused, it's serious, and it requires bold action.
Change that they say needs to happen now.
We have at most 10 years, not 10 years to decide upon action, but 10 years to alter fundamentally the trajectory of global greenhouse gas emissions.
In challenging St. Thomas's core values and raising awareness for a greener planet.
Sustainability shouldn't be this added afterthought. It should be at the forefront of every decision that we're making.
Students are taking part in a global movement.
Mainly, we're showing solidarity with the rest of the youth striking around the world today. Today is the Youth Climate Strike.
Students hope that today's march was not their last.
We're serious about this. This is not just a one-time strike. That this is something that needs to be changed, and we're going to follow up on it.
For TommyMedia.com, I'm Emily Haugen. The students hope their strike would bring attention to the university's new sustainability proposal. If the proposal is approved by student government and President Sullivan, students hope to contribute to the proposal.
Artika Tyner, the Associate Vice President of Diversity and Inclusion, will lead a new center on race, leadership, and social justice. The center is designed to teach students to navigate social justice issues. Tyner's center will combine research, learning, community outreach, and advocacy. Tyner also plans to develop an open call for scholars and individuals looking to be involved with the center. For now, the center will not be a new physical building. Students will meet with Tyner in her office or in one of her classrooms.
Dining Services announced multiple changes coming to on-campus dining next fall, including expanded hours in the View. An unlimited plan is open to all students, but required for first-year residents at $2,175 per semester. St. Thomas hired a new executive chef last semester, Benjamin McCollum, to oversee these changes. McCollum is the first executive chef at St. Thomas in 4 years. Another change includes a G8 allergy station for the 8 most common allergies. The station will be in a separate room at one or both the dining halls on North Campus, coming in fall 2020. Check our website for an interactive graphic to learn how these changes may affect you.
And those are Tommy Media's top stories. Thank you for joining us.
View these stories and more at TommyMedia.com. With Althea Larson, I'm Emily Haugen for Tommy Media's Top Stories.